Valiyathura is well known for its pier. This is the place where the Kerala's own army dwells. This is also a very attractive tourist center in Trivandrum city. In the year 1956, the port was opened by Dr. P.S. Rao, the advisor to the Raja Pramukh of Travancore, and this was the only port along the southern Kerala coast. This 60-year-old port is 703 feet long, that is 214 meters in length, and is sustained by 127 concrete pillars. The pier also had 4 3-ton cranes and 1 10-ton crane to unload goods from the ships harbored. The godowns or the warehouses within this campus are a far cry from the past. The cranes on this pier have vanished, and these godowns are now used as settlement camps of these army personnels and their family members who lost their homes in the sea erosion happened a couple of months before. The most negligence is on the part of our government who ruled over Kerala. The UDF and the LDF both are responsible for this. They had turned away their faces after their victory, and now the BJP promised, but they never came into power, or they are not even given a chance. Both our governments were not ready to do any maintenance in this pier and preserve the port for these starving fishermen or so-called Kerala's army and their families. Instead, they are crying piercingly for an airstrip which does not exist. This logic is very strange. In the olden days, even 50 cargo ships harbored here at a time. Since the pier was located in shallow waters close to the shore, heavy ships had to anchor in the deep sea and transport their consignment in smaller boats to this pier for unloading. With the expansion of Kochi port with facilities for disembarking huge cargo from ships, Valiyathura lost its importance. It was declared a dead port in the early 1980s. All 5 cranes were dismantled and sold as scrap. And years before, 4 godowns were rendered out to industrial unit on the Veli belt before. But now they are used as rescue shelters to the families of these poor fishermen, including women and children who lost their homes in the sea erosion. The rails used by trolleys to transport cargo to the godowns have rusted away. The St. Anthony's Cathedral has the history of more than 500 years, and the New Year Day celebration started here more than 120 years. At the battle between Marthanda Varma and Ettuvittil Pillai, one of the Pillais and his soldiers were protected by these people of Valiyathura. Thus goes the history. Fishing was the main livelihood for the people. Some people work abroad, like in the Gulf and the Middle East countries. Some join the Indian Army, Air Force, Navy, ISRO, VSSC, Travancore Titanium Products Limited, Indian Airport Authority, banks, schools. Many has become medical doctors, engineers, pilots, scientists, police officers, politicians and social workers are born and raised up in Valiyathura. The people of Valiyathura trace back their history more than 500 years. Many Valiyathura people are from the background of Portuguese, Dutch, Spanish and English, whom can be identified with their surnames such as Pereira, Rosario, Voice, Culas, Fernandes, De Silva, De Cruz, Neto, Lopez, Francis, etc. Civilized and peace-loving people are living in the coastal area since centuries ago. Promises are the heart of elections. Some of them are kept, but many remain unkept. It all began when the then Prime Minister, Mr. Rajiv Gandhi, visited this area in 1985. I still remember how he shook hands with all of us and went in one of the huts here. He listened to the grievances of the residents. All of us raised a common demand for a harbor here, which he promised would happen. Soon after his return, the then Kerala State Irrigation Minister, MP Gangadharan, laid the foundation stone for the new pier. The local residents, they were very happy and praised the ruling party. After all, nothing happened. All of those promises made by the government dissolved in the Arabian Sea. The foundation stone laid by the ruling party was a burial stone. Since then, nothing happened. Very recently, Kerala's Minister for Transport, Mr. Antony Raju, said that the lost glory of Valiyathera Pier would be restored and that it would be developed as a hangout for city residents. At the time of election, a clear mandate was only in the dreams of Mr. Raju. Anyway, he managed to win by giving numerous promises. Now, he or the concern never turns back and see the condition of Valiyathera Pier. They might have forgotten. They have lost their memory. Mr. Raju said that preliminary works shall begin within 3 months and it will be completed within 6 months. Sorry to say that, Mr. Raju. You will never see the said preliminary works done before you bows out from the cabinet. He also said that inconvenience of the fishermen community will also be addressed. Nothing is going to be addressed in the near future. The ministers also held discussions with officials regarding recurring instances of coastal erosion. But now, even those ministers and their promises were washed away by the sea erosion. Harbour engineering officials said that IIT has been entrusted with the geotechnical study to restore the pier. The estimate for the works will be prepared by the Harbour Department Chief Engineer. But this estimate never opened its eyes to see the sufferings of these poor people. Even Mr. Raju, who belongs to this society, doesn't open his eyes towards his own people. Then how will this be done by the other cabinet members? With the sea erosion hitting the Valiyathera coast, many houses were washed away and hundreds and thousands have become homeless. The unfulfilled promises by the government to build a seawall at the coast triggered youth and women from Valiyathera to protest in front of the public office building, but that strike was of no use. According to the parish priest of St. Anthony's Faroon Church, the continuous sea erosion occurring in the coast for the past 8 to 9 years have destroyed 5 lanes of houses. The 5 lanes, which include 200 houses till 217, have been destructed due to sea erosion. In 2018, the coast lost around 18 houses till now. The authorities had promised to look into the issue soon after the elections. The government is taking no interest in resolving the issue. Former Minister for Corporation Kadagampally Surendran had promised to address the issue before the rough sea season, but no action has been taken in this regard. Citing the delayed process, the ward councillor of Bhimapalli, Mr. Rashid, said, "I tried my best to convince the higher officials regarding the matter. The situation is an emergency and the government should take actions to consider the issue, rather giving importance to the norms. But nobody heard this. Everybody knows that there is no point in blowing a trumpet in deaf ears." The geographical boundary of Valiyathera Parish till the beginning of 20th century extended from Shankumugam to Bhimapalli. Later, the parish was separated. Consequently, the parishes of St. Anne's Church, Valiyathera, Assumption Church, Chariyathura, St. Saviour's Church, Valiyathera, and finally Fatima Mada Church, Kochathop, came into existence. The famous pilgrim center Madre de Deus Church at Vettagard is part of Valiyathera Faroon Church. Valiyathera is 5 kilometers from the city center. Privately owned and KSRTC buses ply from East Fort. Auto rickshaws can also be hired. A bypass of National Highway 47 passes 1 kilometer to the east of Valiyathura. The nearest railway station is Thiruvananthapuram Central, around 8 kilometers away. Shankhamukham Beach and Bhimapalli Mosque are tourist attractions nearby. Educational institutions in Valiyathura are St. Anthony's Higher Secondary School, St. Anthony's Lower Primary School, Government Regional Fisheries High School, Government UP and LP Schools, and also there are more than 8 private educational institutions serving the students. This is Valiyathura, and this is the importance of Valiyathura. And the government are not turning their blind eyes towards in maintaining the pier. Have a nice time. Bye.